Scott Ochoa here, and welcome to the Scott Ochoa Show on YouTube. And today, I play for you nothing. I'm not playing a thing because I don't know how to play the piano. But fortunately for my ears and your ears, I have a musical guest, Chris Lovejoy. Chris, come on over.
Scott, how are you?
I'm good. How are you,
Chris? It's good to see you, my friend.
Thank you for taking time out of your day to visit with me and be part of the show.
Sure.
The show focuses on how are we happy? What do we do for a living? What do we do that's passionate?
What are we passionate about?
And you're very passionate about music. I've known you for quite a few years, and I know you've worked in music forever. So tell us a little bit about yourself, and tell us about your music and your passion. And
well, yeah, I've done something in music ever since I was little bitty. My family has sang together for years. My sisters are on the road a lot, singing now even. And I was a high school band director for 20 years in the music part of the public school system. And so I came about 7 years ago out of that into full-time church ministry and music-wise. So my greatest passion is for the Lord, then my wife and family, you know, and then music. But music is such a wonderful part of communicating God's love even to people. Yeah,
music is a very strong communicator and a very big driver, depending on the music and how the songs are done. But, I mean, it's a big driver of emotion, too,
which is
really cool. And that's something we'll touch on, you know, when we talk about your music that you've produced, that you've made. And I'm glad you mentioned priorities with your God and your family and your music, because that's something that's very important to not only have balance, but to, you know, just feel good about life. Is you have to have that structure, too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If you let your passion, you know, get out of balance, and you're constantly doing what you're passionate about, but then you don't spend time with the Lord, you don't spend time with family, you have those out of whack and out of order, you won't get to be as happy as you can. So that's very important for us to note too. So it's been about a year and a half, and you had a CD, you released a CD about a year and a half ago. And that was part of you just listening to the Lord. Tell us your story and how that came about.
Wow. When I was in college, I started writing down some words. I remember driving to college. It was 4 hours away. So I would drive, and on the road, I would stop and jot down on a napkin words that I felt like were coming to me in rhythm, rhymes and such as that. But then I was a band director for 20 years, and I really never did anything with that. It's not until I surrendered to just full-time ministry that all of a sudden the songs started coming. And I actually went to Colorado to Estes Park to a music conference. The Gospel Music Association had a music conference there every year for 30-something years. And I got my feet wet in this because I said, you know, ask the people, what do I do with all these songs? And they said, well, use them in the simple ways. Go to nursing homes, play them there. You know, God will move them and make them more if He wishes. And so that's kind of where that started.
And then your CD has come out, and I was there at the CD release, which was great.
Oh, thank you.
I enjoyed seeing you play, and of course, hearing it live and on CD, I mean, they're completely different sounds, you know, so you have the live sound versus the CD sound. Or of course, I didn't buy the CD, I bought the iTunes version, so Chris is going to play some music for us here in a minute, and if you are so inclined to check out his other songs, I'm going to post a link in this video or below this video at YouTube where you can check out his music. They have the album out on iTunes, and you can hear their little snippets. You're going to play some snippets for us, but you also have a chance to buy it if you so choose. I mean, that's not necessarily our purpose. We're here to share a message, but it doesn't hurt that, you know, we make money every now and then too. So
sure.
I'm going to turn it over to you for just to do a couple snippets for
us,
and then I'll come back and we'll talk just another minute more, and we'll wrap up.
Sure, thank you.
All right.
When I lift my eyes to your mighty throne, and I see your majesty, and I see myself small as I am, you love me still. How amazing, how amazing.
love reaches down to me. How amazing, how amazing. You love me still.
Yeah, Scott, that was the fifth song, I think, on the album. And so here's the first song. Little snippet of it anyway.
Who is this one who spoke creation? Who is this one who brings salvation? Who is this one mighty to save? Who is this one raised from the grave? Who is this one? He is my God. He is my King. Jesus, the reason I sing.
Couple snippets.
Man, that was awesome.
Hey, thank you. Thank
Thanks
you.
For playing for us.
Thank you.
Yeah, I really enjoy the CD, and there's a lot of subtle layers. Now, we're only hearing the piano part, uh-huh. but there's, of course, other instruments there. There's some subtle layers. There's some bass line uh-huh. in there, and man, the layers of music just really came out good, and I really enjoy the sound of the CD. You did a great job.
Hey, thank you. Chad Carruthers, the recording artist, or studio, actually, he is the show producer for Phillips, Craig, and Dean. He's in Nashville now, but he did a great job. And wow. So I owe him so much. He added so much to it. Instrumentally, he played a lot of the instruments. And Brad Knight played drums live. And so a lot of good help.
That's great. Well, you're a great example of, you know, someone who's pursuing your passion just one step at a time. And like most of us, we have to take baby steps. It's not, you know, overnight, you know, life has just changed. Right. And, you know, I started doing something a week ago and now all of a sudden I'm a superstar. It doesn't work that way. And I think we get blinded by all of the stories of celebrities. Yeah. And you go to the checkout stand, and this is a big pet peeve of mine. You go to the checkout stand and you see all those tabloids or whatever. And they're right. like, look at, you know, Justin Bieber's new car and he's 22 or it's very disheartening. Right. So, you know, that's part of the show is, we're real people, you know. I can reach out and touch you, and you're not on a pedestal, and you're pursuing your passion. And well, that's a good message.
There's an important thing you just said. Passion is not limited to an age. Mm-hmm. And I started when I was 50. Okay, and I've tried to teach my kids that you're never too old to pursue something and pursue an adventure. And I think it's real important to keep learning, to keep pursuing, and it's a great adventure. It's really fun.
Well, and the great thing about maturing in your passion is you also end up getting more resources to do your passion as time mm-hmm. goes along. So
sure.
what's difficult today is actually easy tomorrow, and yeah. a small project that you have today can be a big project
sure.
you know in 6 months or
sure.
a year because you're smarter about it. You know, things are coming easier, and you're getting better at your passion.
And also connections.
You
can't say enough for connections because I did yes. not know the guys I'm working with now in these recording, Johnny Vogt's another from Gateway Worship in Dallas. Mm-hmm. And I'm about to go record a Christmas song, actually. Here it is.
Cool.
What is it? March. Record a Christmas song this Friday with him. And so, I did not know these guys 10 years ago.
Right.
So God places them and when it's time. When it's
right.
time.
Well, the saying goes, it's not what you know, but who you know.
Sure, that's
and to a great extent, that's true. I mean, you have to know something, otherwise you're not
right, sure.
competent enough to do mm-hmm. do whatever the subject matter is. But yeah, it makes a big difference because they can really, having those connections, having people that are working in your passion area can pull you forward
yes.
much faster than you can do it by
yeah.
yourself. So
sure.
that's something important, too. If you're pursuing your passion, and I hope you do, I hope you know what it is, or at least you have some inkling of what it is, reach out and connect with other people that are in that same passion area. So Chris is not a music producer, but he's an artist, he's a musician, so he can make the music. But now that he has connections with producers and other musicians, his projects are a lot easier. So that's
sure.
kind of the point is, you know, just reach out and connect with other people, and you know, your passion will start growing, which would be great. And it'll feel awesome. I bet you feel awesome when you're playing your music when your CD was done. I bet you were just elated.
it's an awesome relief to finish a project, and you do feel good about it. And the fact is that God is using some of these songs in churches across America, which I am blown away
That's
about.
That's awesome.
I would have never thought that. And so God has really moved it on in spite of my small thinking.
Well, you know, when I listened to it, if you are familiar with Mercy Me, I thought it had a lot of the Mercy Me kind of vibe to it.
Oh, thank you.
As far as, you know, when I listen to their album, I listen to your album, I'm getting the jazzed up and I'm having the emotional swings. I'm getting, you know, almost teary eyed on some of them. Like, oh man, driving down the road and okay.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Well, to be compared to Barton Miller's group at all, I'm just like, that's beautiful.
Well, that's what I thought of when I listened to it. I didn't make it up.
Thank you.
Driving down the road from your CD release, I'm like, this reminds me of Mercy Me, and you know, which is a group that I've
liked. Wonderful. I love those guys too. They're wonderful. They sure are.
Well, thanks for tuning in. This is Chris Lovejoy. Check him out at the link below at iTunes. You can hear more of his music. And, of course, his songs have all of the instruments rather than just the piano that we heard today. I thank you for your time. I'm going to leave it with Chris. He's going to play a little snippet as we fade out. And I'll see you next time.
Thanks Chris. My friend. Thank you.
For the glory of your name, save us, save us. For the glory of your name, save us, save us.